Hello everybody, what is up? My name is King Spinach, and welcome back to my Borderlands 2 Handsome Collection walkthrough. We're gonna sprint through this first section of the Bloodshot Stronghold as we had to go do the Splinter Group quest, and, this one. I forgot about this mission, too. Yeah, so that, this out-of-body experience quest is also actually kind of cool. Because you can get a decent shield and a decent shotgun, but more importantly, a decent shield. Unfortunately, the shield likes to talk when you get hit and stuff, and same with the shotgun. It's one of those guns that talks to you because there's an AI core in it. And that can get a little annoying at times. I'm just gonna let Death Trap go while I, you know, just sit here and, you know, kinda look at the chest, see what we got. Nice and easy. Just kinda relax and taking it slow. Wow, this gun actually fires way faster than I thought it did. Oh, dang. Didn't want to kill myself there accidentally. Deathtrap, you should probably kill somebody for me really, really fast, because I don't think I'm going to make it otherwise. Oh, did Deathtrap go away? No, why'd he go away? Why would you do that? Oh my god, that was so close. These guys are screaming. It's so weird, but it's so funny at the same time. Alright, so... so this quest is actually just a kind of Easter egg type deal, making fun of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. We're gonna have to basically kill all the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and I think we can also kill their leader, Splinter. But I don't know what the actual code is to get Splinter to, spawn, so, I don't think we'll be able to kill him today. Just because I don't know the code. If I knew the code, then maybe. Alright, now we get to fight all four at once. And these guys all count as like badass enemies too, so they're all worth a lot of XP when you kill them. I have a large pile of blood money with your name on it. Yeah, that's one of the biggest reasons. You would be incorrect. Yeah, that's one of the biggest reasons I do this quest, is because it is 1800 XP per one of them that you kill. I think, hold on, ready? One, two, and then I think it's... and then, one more time, nope, I was wrong, and then maybe this, nope, I'm totally wrong, alright, I'm totally wrong, forget it, you just gotta get all those things, green, all those lights green, in order to spawn him. None of those mods are better than our grenade, currently, neither are those things, so... we get to actually just completely get out of the Bloodshot Stronghold now, so we're gonna... what we're gonna do is we're basically gonna sprint run... where do I go? Oh. We're gonna speed run through the entire thing, so we're just gonna kinda run past all the enemies, and that's what Deathtrap is gonna help us out with. He's probably gonna make it way easier for us to just ignore these guys, and run through this area so that we can get to the end of the area, and then move on to Bloodshot Ramparts, where we get to install this body core for the... or the AI core for the out-of-body experience quest. Oh, come on. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, you have to kill people here. Dang it. Dang it, I hate it when they make you kill people. Come on, come on, come on. There he he's going down, he's going down. Just need Mad Mike to spawn. Nomad Torturer. He's down. You get to kill the angry midget. That's okay, because we're going to be able to kill these guys really, really easy. Mad Mike is no trouble either. And the rest of this is pretty much smooth sailing. So, just going to kind of run through here. And I see that toilet chest off to the side, but no need to really grab it. I'm just going to keep going. Get a little bit of extra XP with the kills from that grenade there. Some low effort XP, which I feel like this whole series is going to be super, like, maybe not low effort, maybe that's not the best word to describe it, but like, you don't really need to, like, focus as much when you're playing, because you just have Death Trap to do everything. I don't think we ever picked up that one either, so. Alright, now this is actually really good that we got this purple pistol straight out of the thing for no reason. Like, I've never seen a purple gun in there ever, I don't think. I've never seen a purple gun in an item of the day. I've seen blues. I don't think I've ever seen a purple. I know it happens, it's very rare though. So we should definitely take advantage of it every time it pops up. And, oh god, if only my accuracy was a little better. Oh, Jesus. I think that's the only, that's the downside of this gun, the accuracy. But, we're basically only going to be using it on Hyperion dudes, exclusively. And maybe some Varkids that end up being badass or mutated badass Varkids. Just because those guys are armored. So, it's probably going to be a switch off between that shotgun, because that's flame damage. So that can kill bandits and Varkids that are not mutated badass ones really quickly, and then this gun, which will kill everything else really quickly. So this could be a little power team of weapons for the moment. Whew. We'll install the AI core. Let's just use our SMG here. Take down these nomads before, you know, too long. I was just like, I was wondering, like, where are these guys even at? I can't even find them. God, I kind of don't even want to get critical hits with this gun, just because I just can't see. Look at that freaking, like, electric blast thing. I just can't see when it happens. So, just not worth it. And that is a constructor in the background, but, you know, we're not going to worry about it too much. I'm not going to worry about it at all, because that's actually a friend. Install the AI core. And boom, we get betrayed. So let's take it out. Let's take out the constructor. Bombed. Come on, Death Trap. Don't let me down. Do some damage, Death Trap. Do some damage. Let's go. Oh, Death Trap is just not helping out here at all. Oh, he's fighting other dudes. He doesn't have time for this. I'm gonna pick up the AI core again. He's trying to buy our faith. I don't know. I don't know, we'll see, we'll see.
Oh,
keep running away. Run past. Oh, wait, no, we have to go back over there. That's where the thing is. Dang it. I'm sure you guys all knew it. You're all telling me to go back there. Shouting at your screens. And we're just gonna wait. Just keep shooting. Nah. Such a weird noise. Such a weird laugh. Oh, he's a liar. Oh, jeez. Oh. Not a fan of those. Not a fan of those shield surveyors. Man, my accuracy with this gun. Yeah, Domori got those suckers. Oh, I'm gonna let him lay into me, actually. Actually. Oh, yeah, he wants to be in a radio. Oh, okay, I remember what happens. So what we're actually going to do, though, is still run through the rest of this area. Reason being is that if we did this whole save and exit trick, which is a commonly known trick for making Borderlands run a little bit faster, it's when you save and exit, and then it spawns you at the beginning of an area, usually next to a fast travel point, and that makes it a little bit easier for you to kind of get to another area using the fast travel really, really fast. What we're going to do instead is run to the end of this area and then use the fast travel point at the end of this area, because there is no fast travel at the beginning of this area, and if we did save an exit, we'd end up at the beginning of this area, and then we'd have to walk all the way back through the Bloodshot Dam to get to a fast travel. And I'm not about to do that. I don't want to do that. That's not how I want to live my life. I am going to have to go down here, though, and then switch to my shotgun. Hopefully. Kill this nomad right here. Nailed it. I'm also gonna just drop a nade there in case I get hit. Okay, we are going down again, which kinda sucks. That's okay, because this shotgun is too good. I don't even know if I want to replace it. It's so good. And let's try not to travel to the unassuming docks this time. Just go to Sanctuary straight up, where we can actually cash in both of these missions relatively quickly. Yeah, so we're going to go and... So the radio you put him into kind of plays for a little bit. So we're going to go put him into the radio and then run away, cash in the Splinter Group mission, and then go back to the radio later and do whatever else we have to do. Nice and easy. We got a plan. We got a plan. That's what matters. And he betrays us once again. And we can't hear it from all the way over here, but I'm sure we'll hear it by the time we go back. He plays some god-awful music. Hammerlock and Moxie are actually just, like, saying, please, no, make it stop. Like, everybody in the whole club is being, like, awful. And now we have to kill the radio, because he's just playing just bad tunes. Bad tunes that we can't handle. So we're gonna make it over there. We'll kill the radio, transform him into either the shotgun or the shield. I'm not sure. Well, we'll see. We'll see. Take it to Marcus. Marcus is closer, so that's my logic here.
You want this AI thingy in a gun? Fine, but just this once.
Critical shotgun 1439. Now we'll just compare this shotgun to that. Our slicing dog is a little better, but the double-barreled rock salt is better. don't retreat, just reload? Oh my god, this thing is rocking. I'm a fan of the rock salt. I'm a fan. It is a bandit gun too, so it has an extra high ammo count, which is really nice. Oh, now next skill point we have, we can, instead of putting it into shock storm, we should put it into shock and awe, just because the electrical explosion is really, really good. I feel like that's gonna come in super duper handy. And electrocute status effects. We need to start getting some shock weapons. We don't have any shock weapons, so we should probably, you know, probably get one of those. And then next episode, we're gonna head to Tundra Express because we actually have a few missions pertaining to things over there. So we're gonna go to Tundra Express and then do the Varkid thing while we're there, and then we'll probably meet up with Roland Spy and do a little bit more of those quests. We'll probably finish the Tundra Express storyline, little mini like side quest storyline type thing, in the next two or three episodes. So yeah, that's the plan. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, please don't be afraid to leave a like, comment, favorite, and subscribe. It really helps support me, helps support the channel, and lets me know that you guys love watching this series as much as I love making it. I'll see you all next time, but until then, I'm out. Peace.